Stop. Do not make this MacBook buying mistake. What's up, people? This your boy Viper, the man about tech, back again for the video. And lately online, there's been a big discussion about whether or not 8 gigabytes of RAM versus 16 gigabytes of RAM is enough for a MacBook when you are looking to make a MacBook buying decision. But before we can even get into how much RAM is appropriate for you, we need to go over what RAM is. So, in case you don't know, RAM stands for Random Access Memory, RAM. And basically, it is the computer's short-term memory. RAM controls the operating system. It stores the application program, data in current use, data that the processor is trying to use. Basically, the RAM controls everything that the computer is doing at a particular moment in time. How many applications are you running simultaneously? How many is determined, large part, into how much RAM your computer has. 8 gigabytes versus 16 gigabytes. I'm going to venture to guess that most people who are buying computers are just normal, everyday people. So you're probably not doing anything more on your computer than things like web browsing, answering emails, video consumption, maybe even social media on your computer. I don't know. But these are basic tasks that do not require a large amount of RAM for you to be able to do them. Even if you're doing them all at the same time, these are not things that you need a large amount of RAM for in your computer. But if you are more of a professional level person using your computer and you're doing things on the order of video editing, 3D rendering, game design, programming, maybe you're doing AI machine learning type stuff with your computer. If you're doing heavy hitting, computing intensive processes like that, you need more RAM. But back to my earlier point, most of you all out there aren't doing the stuff that I just alluded to. So in my opinion, the average everyday person buying a MacBook, you don't need more than 8 gigabytes of RAM. But if you are a professional level user of this MacBook, you're probably looking at a MacBook Pro at minimum. And at the very minimum, you should not touch anything less than 16 gigabytes of RAM if you're professional. And I would even go further. If you're a professional, like myself, you're a content creator, I wouldn't go less than 32 gigabytes of RAM just to give yourself enough headroom to make sure that you have all the RAM that you need to run all the applications that you want to run in real time simultaneously on your MacBook. Again, if you're a content creator, you're doing video editing, maybe you're working in Photoshop, or maybe you're a programmer, or maybe you're a film director and you're doing heavy 3D stuff, or maybe you're like a game designer and you're doing game design, 3D rendering and AI stuff, then yes, go for the more RAM. Again, I would not touch anything less than 32 personally, but if you're doing that much big time stuff, you're probably doing what I did and maxing out your RAM at 128 gigabytes anyway. But I just wanted to clear up this conversation about RAM because I feel like, in my opinion, 95% of you all out there buying a MacBook, you're just doing regular tasks like web browsing, emailing. And for that stuff, you don't need a computer more than 8 gigabytes of RAM, especially with the way Apple handles RAM with the optimization that they have on their MacBook Pro. But let me know, how much RAM do you have in your computer? Is it 8? Is it 16? Is it more? Maybe you have an older computer and you only have 4 gigabytes of RAM. Drop a comment, let me know, and make sure you're following the captain of Team Apple for all things Apple.